doing last night? You were up pretty late, weren't you?
Yeah, just doing my writing, man.
Yeah, what class?
It's from our literature class. We actually watched this French play called The Barber of Seville.
Ugh.
Yeah.
What's that about?
Had a sick storyline, you know, guy-girl drama, political issues, all the goody-toodies.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Sounds pretty sweet. So, like, are you happy taking that class, or...?
Yeah, I mean, it's all right. I've been actually thinking of writing my lyrics based off of it.
Classic conservatory student.
Hey, man. What are you up to, bro?
I mean, I don't know. I was up pretty late, too. I went to bed.
Yeah, your desk light was on till, like, 2 o'clock in the morning?
Yeah.
What was that about?
No, it was, like, 4:30. I don't know. I've been writing this cool new piece. I think it's going to be pretty good. Pretty excited for it, but...
Wait, yeah, where are you headed off to right now?
I got history of Europe. It's so dumb. Like,
oh, you weren't working on your history homework?
No. Why would I do history homework? I lived it. Like, I'm probably gonna go talk to the prof and tell him off or something. Like, I already know everything, so why bother?
Yo, why don't you say that to Professor K's face? I want to see his reaction.
All right, I will then, Lorenzo.
Yeah, I'll see you at Saga 12.
Oh yeah, totally, dude. You know what it is? Austrian goulash.
Little taste of
home. All right,
man.
All right, see you later, Lorenzo.
You tell Professor K off, right?
All right, I will.
So what's the problem, Mozart? You're a bright kid. Why don't you put any effort in this class?
I mean, okay, Professor K, look. I grew up in Europe with my dad, touring all over the place. So I know, like, the back of my hand. Like, literally. And... I mean, I care about Europe right now, but it's just, I don't know, I haven't been able to get to your homework, that's why.
Well, your grade is reflecting on it, so you better work on this, otherwise you won't pass the test.
All right, Professor K, thanks, I will.
Come back anytime.
Okay, thanks, Professor K. Yes. Oh, man. Dude, I wish it was Chicken Tenders Day here.
Dude, right? Like, I'm just so getting tired of this saga food.
I'm
man.
Sick of history. It's awful.
Yo, speaking of history, what did your history professor say about you not doing the work?
I just told him, you know, I'm not gonna do it. I don't feel like doing my homework.
Yeah, it's like,
but it doesn't even matter, you know.
Gen eds, man.
No, dude. You know what really matters?
Yo,
tell me about this little stage play you've been working on.
Dude, I've been waiting for you to ask me.
Dude.
Yo, I took tons of notes and I've been working till like 4:30 in the morning, bro.
Give me the lowdown.
Alright. Okay, so it's interesting, Mozart. There's gonna be two characters, right?
It's gonna
be Figaro and his fiancée, Susanna.
Mm, right? Strong name.
They work for the Count, the sketchy guy that wants to take everyone's bride in their wedding.
Dude, that sounds
and
fire.
Figaro is trying to stop him and reveal what a phony he is.
Okay.
And there's
okay.
a theme of anti-aristocracy.
Oh, yeah.
What do you think about that?
Dude, that sounds like so
it's
good.
It's dope, right?
Like, I wish I could watch that right now.
Dude,
like,
it's gonna be blockbuster.
Do you have, like, music to set it to? Or, like, have you been thinking about that?
Oh,
or?
Dude. With my genius lyrics and your instrumentation, dude,
yeah.
It's gonna be a hit,
dude,
bro.
Let's...
Alright, so you were telling me that you wanted to do an opera. Can you tell me more about that?
Yeah. So, here, I actually have some notes too, you know?
You know what I'm saying?
So, like, I was thinking, like, opera buffa.
Oh,
you know?
I do love the sound of that.
It's kind
of
new, but you know what I mean?
Yeah,
it's a opera buffa comic opera.
Yeah.
You know, I've been doing some sacred pieces, and you can only do so much. So,
oh, yeah, totally agree,
so I'm
man.
Thinking of doing some secular pieces, but... Dude, wait, whoa, you okay, man? Whoa, what's going on?
Bro, secular pieces?
Well, yeah, I mean, you gotta switch it up every now and then, you know?
Bro, that's kind of risky, isn't it?
No, come on, I'm Mozart, I do what I want.
Oh,
but,
okay, you're trying to start a new trend, alright, I like
that. Yeah, but like, you know, it sounds like there's like some emotion in this stage play you've got. And you know me, I love making like emotions and music match each other, so like...
Oh, yeah.
I could totally work on this, make it good.
Oh, but in order for that to happen, you need the right instruments.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
What are you thinking?
That's right. All right, let's see. I was thinking some flutes.
Oh, yeah.
Some oboes, you know, some clarinets. Maybe some bassoons, horns, trumpets, timpani.
Charisma. Yeah.
Probably some strings, you know?
Yeah.
You know, send it off. Maybe get a little keyboard in there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? Maybe write in sonata form. Man, I love sonata form. You know what I'm talking about?
Loving the vibe.
The three-part structure with the exposition, the development, and the recapitulation. Oh. Ah. Muy bueno.
Mozart.
Yo, what's up?
Four acts.
Okay.
The climax at the end. It'll be perfect for the comic book.
Okay. Dude, Lorenzo, that sounds so good. What if this got huge? Like, dude, this could be a big... Vienna? The Berg Theater premiere?
No, man.
1786. It'd be the biggest thing of the year.
You gotta think bigger, what? Man.
Bigger? What's bigger than Vienna?
Chicago.
Chicago.
Dude, imagine this amount of thousands of audience.
Oh my gosh. Okay, hey, let's not get ahead of ourselves. We gotta write the thing first.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
So.
I mean, it sounds good. Sounds good.
What do you think?
I'm in.
Okay.
It actually works.
Okay? All right.
But
like,
I gotta tell you before we get started on anything that I'll be writing this in Italian.
Okay.
Because I wanna be
sticking to
my roots.
Dude, Lorenzo, you do you, man.
Dude.
Okay? Alright, hey, you start doing the lyrics and all that. Hey.
Alright, hold on.
Well, all right, what's going on?
Something about...
Oh, yeah, Figaro. Yeah. We gotta name it. Figaro...
And the wedding.
Marriage of Figaro!
Bro! It's been a rule! All right, do it!
I'll start writing that music.
Yeah, dude, better get cracking.
Just taking a short break from our rehearsal of Marriage Figaro, Act 4. Got Wolfgang Mozart over here. Our sopranos and altos are fantastic. About to get work done.
All right, guys, enough chit-chat. Back to work. Top of the fourth. Let's go.
Oh, my gosh, Mozart. Our opera troupe was talking, and we, like, love this song.
Okay.
No, seriously, it's so good. I just love singing songs from Vienna composers because there's just so many Italian composers.
Hey!
Oh, not to say anything against you, Lorenzo, but really, it's kind of like a rivalry that Vienna composers have for getting the opera troupes to sing their songs.
Yeah, bro. Okay, hey, enough of this little yippy-yappy. Back to work, let's go, come on. You ready? From the top of the fourth.
No, I really love it.
I like how Mozart's music makes me feel like it's not just about Mozart, it's about me too.
No, it's about me, so let's get back to work. Marriage of Figaro, so good, right?
Really
so
great.
Good.
It was awesome.
Hey, what'd you think of Marriage of Figaro?
What?
How'd you think of Marriage of Figaro?
Just go across till 3.
Gotta text Lorenzo. All right, here we go. Lorenzo, swag money for days? Where do you even get this stuff, kid?
Excuse me, are you Amadeus Mozart?
Why, yes, I am.
Oh my gosh, I can't believe you're here. I love your work. The Marriage of Figaro completely transformed the comic opera.
Thank you, that's very kind of you to say.
You are a genius of classical music.
Yeah, I mean, I just do my best, you know what I can?
The
you
Magic
I mean?
Flute, The Marriage of Figaro. I can't believe you're here.
Well, it's me.
Is it true that you conducted The Marriage of Figaro for the first two opening performances in Vienna at the Burg Theater from the keyboard?
This is true. You know, it's customary for composers to conduct the first pieces from the keyboard. You know that, right?
Can I have your autograph?
Oh, of course. Luckily, I come prepared for all of these situations.
So, Marriage of Figaro was a success for Mozart. With its premiere on May 1st, 1786 in Vienna, it saw much popularity throughout Europe and is still enjoyed today. While Mozart and libretto writer Lorenzo DuPont,
can't forget Lorenzo,
actual roommates, are gone to Wheaton College, they did work on a few operas together. Mozart transformed the opera buffa genre and is one of the most popular composers of the classical period. His use of sonata and wide range of music of writing secured him a spot in history as one of music's greats.